Ghetto niggas strutting with nothing but dreams and queens broke. Mac-10s, you can smell a PCP smoke. Melly Mel told it real in the music he wrote. Those were the days I remember. We used to be close, then I was 9. Coldest winter I remember was slipping in December, 2 feet of snow. Yeah, that's the East Coast. That black ice symbolized the rap life. It was slick and smooth. I understood that.
Welcome to the Bronx Terminal Market, 610 Exterior Street, where you can witness the Revolution of Hip Hop exhibit. It is the first exhibit running by the Universal Hip Hop Museum, and it is featuring artifacts, memorabilia, and equipment from the early 1970s and the early days of hip hop. We are setting up this exhibit, and it will be running for the next 3 years, and we will be changing exhibitions every 6 months. So from now until June, we will be running an exhibition covering the early days of hip hop in the early 1970s. In June, we will be moving into the 1980s, and we will be moving forward every 6 months until we open across the street in 2023. Okay, what you're looking at is a hip hop history tree and timeline based on the five elements of hip hop. So when we first start, we look at the center of the tree, and you can see the third eye for knowledge, which is one of the elements of hip hop. And down at the root of the tree, you can see the address, 1520 Cedric Avenue, Bronx, New York, which is the place where DJ Kool Herc and the Herculoids had their first hip hop party. As the tree grows, it grows into the other elements, and you can look over here. You can see the aerosol art can with Tacky 183. You look further down, you can see the Adidas sneakers for the breakdancers and the B-boys and B-girls. There's a shout out to Wild Style the movie. The Sugar Hill Gang is on the floor. We have the Universal Almighty Zulu Nation. We have a tribute to Yo MTV Raps. If you look on this side, you can see another element. You can see the turntables representing the DJ with Grandmaster Flash and the Furious Five. Above that, you can see the microphone, and there's a shout out to MC Sha-Rock and Mr. Magic Rap Attack Radio. A little further north, you can see the gold chains for the bling era with the Yankee fitted cap for the East Coast and the LA Raiders cap for the West Coast. To the far top on the right, above the Adidas, you can see the dollar sign for the Get Money in Harlem, Get Money Around the Country in Hip Hop. And you have the Black Power sign and the President Obama logo. On the bottom, what you see is some influences that were predating hip hop. You see things like Dennis Coffey, who made great break beats, the Last Poets, who were doing spoken word prior to the formation of hip hop culture, James Brown, who was giving us the soul and Say It Loud and Black and I'm Proud, and all of the soul music that was influencing the early era of hip-hop. Jimmy Castor, who made one of the most famous breakbeats, Has Just Begun, that the B-boys and B-girls danced to. Gil Scott-Heron, who created what we consider one of the first rap records called The Revolution Would Not Be Televised. And when you combine all of these elements and you put it all together, you get a comprehensive idea of what was happening in the 1970s in hip-hop. Okay, what we're looking at here is a digital hip-hop timeline that covers the generation from the early 1960s to the late 1970s. And it's a comprehensive look at everything that was going on social, economically, and politically in America, in terms of the elements that created the backbone and the cornerstones for hip hop music. So if you scroll through this timeline, as you can see, it gives different information. Like, for example, this is the 5% youth movement in Harlem. The 5% Nation was one of the early influences spiritually, mathematically, and politically for the hip hop community. And we can move a little further and you might see something else. Like, for example, there's a teacher strike when New York City schools shut down for 2 months. Again, I say this is a comprehensive timeline with all of the activity that was happening early in the 70s. Here we are looking at Hip Hop Ho Avenue peace meeting between rival gangs in the Bronx. It's a real comprehensive look at our history and our culture. Very detailed, very descriptive, animated, and visual. And there's QR codes that you can get from off the side of the wall where you can download this timeline and you can actually have it in your phone.
Hip-hop will never, never.
Ghetto niggas strutting with nothing but dreams and Queens broke. Mac 10s, you can smell a PCP smoke. Melly Mel told it real in the music he wrote. Those were the days I remember. We used to be close, then I was 9. Coldest winter I remember was slipping in December. 2 feet of snow. Yeah, that's the East Coast. That black ice symbolized the rap life. It was slick and smooth. I understood I had to come from the hood, doing the Pee Wee Herman, the Smurf, before them phones chirp. The block's drugs flowing, didn't have your own work. You had to have somebody else's. A small chrome on your pelvis, starter jacket, blue Georgetown, a green Celtic. Your girl's too expensive, she wants shellfish. Red Lobster was popping, standing on that line forever. I wish somebody would step on my Bally Leathers. Now it's whatever. Hip-hop's forever.